Sí.
Level up at any moment. Spitting like a semi, only give me semicolon. Couple zeros like I'm sending yell nets. Every flow is unmatched, and I better get set in. Finish them, finish them.
Mess around with me and I diminish them all. Even if I ever did the minimum all.
In the end result, I'm better killing them all. Rogue one, but I got a team with me. Batman when I got a thing with me. I get mean, I get green. Show the whole game what's never been seen. Cook it up. It's top rank.
Designer sneakers hurt my feet now. Every beat is getting beat down. Couldn't eat, well, watch I eat now. Like, how you getting paid to freestyle? Different cities every week now. Every woman is now. What state prop you looking bleak now? I was home to sleep designing sheets now. 30 different missions. When I speak, they listen. Couldn't find the social fishing. Who the crew? It wasn't you. I know it's true because you look like the opposition. Run it up, greatest ever sums it up. I ain't have a lot when I was coming up. Kinda made my stomach turn when I brung it up. Wait,
cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank. Cook it up.
All right, coach, we are pleased as always to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Carolina Panthers and the Atlanta Falcons. The first 2 months of the regular season down. What will the final two bring us as we're off in week nine? This will be taken very short. And they'll have good starting field position as he's up just shy of the 40. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Watch the slats. Watch the slats.
Watch the twist. Watch the twist.
Hey, 133. Let's go. Let's go.
First rep of the game for Josh Jacobs. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. But you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
Eight yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2. On second down, Jacobs. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. 7 yards there and a first down.
But we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and 2, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
Play action now. Here's Mayfield. And this one into the hands of DJ Shark. A very solid gain of 27.
The goal for any offense versus his own defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route.
Hey, alert, 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 alert. Real.
Here's Jacobs on first and 10. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Josh Jacobs with touchdown number 7 on the year. As his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Extra point splits the uprights. And it's now a 7-0 game. the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
On the double.
Not today, you know. Not today.
61, Matchbox Lights.
Back.
Go.
They start on the ground with Geis. He'll have a first down past the 40. A big play on the ground there. It goes for 36 yards.
Sometimes those lines that are drawn on a grease board or in a playbook, they come to life out on the field, don't they? And we just saw that on that outside handoff to the right.
That right tackle, he gets excited for that call, doesn't he?
He does, because he just wants to dominate his guy. And say, listen, I was the point of attack. I took care of business. That's why you're able to get downfield and add all those yards to your total.
Yeah, really nice gain there. They'll run for the first time with Austin Eckler. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
A gain of four. It's now second and six at the Falcons' 35-yard line.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six.
Watch the screen. 218, chop.
Kill. Turn up. Kill. Turn up.
Go.
Check 49.
Watch twist. Pro team spell. There. Ready.
Geis. Just a gain of a yard there. Now it'll be third down.
It's a shutdown, right? Yeah.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense.
Tens the mic.
Know your job. Hey. Pilot, 64. Wait.
Check 31.
Here is Eckler. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. And a loss of three to bring up four. I'm no offensive mastermind, but of all the guys on the field to block, you might want to stop him.
Look, I've got a very simple rule. An unblocked defender is usually your best defender, and he ended up making the play there.
So here we go. The offense is going to stay out there. They're going for it on fourth and eight. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And my goodness, this is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Falcons' defense stands tall. They'll get the football back. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number one seed.
And that's a great spot to be in, but I love the phrase, if it ended today. And I'll guarantee you, that's what they've discussed in their locker room, in their meeting rooms. Yeah, we know where we'd be if it ended today, but we also know it's not ending today.
Right.
So they've got to continue to play the type of ball that put them in the spot where they're number one in their conference.
On first down, Jacobs. And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Brings up second and nine at the 49-yard line.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Mayfield off the play fake. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. You know darn well both of these teams reviewed the film and saw that this defense had 5 sacks last week. They got to keep their QB upright.
And they're going to try their best to do exactly that. But they're facing a team where getting to the quarterback is a mindset. It's a mantra for them. And they play a game within the game. And you know what it is? Let's race to the quarterback and see who gets there first.
Mayfield on play action. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
The Falcons send out their punter. Back deep, the former All-Pro Tyler Lockett. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. And oh, that is gonna be a safety. And you know, the man who sat in my chair the last few years, he has a theory. These plays, these safeties, they're so rare. Maybe they should be worth more than 2, maybe 4 points.
I think he's got a great point. I really do, Brandon. But I would go ahead and up it to 6. I'm a former defender. Ooh. To me, that's like scoring a touchdown.
Easy now. I'll go 4. I don't know about 6.
Come on. Come up to 6.
Points. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and get punted away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
It's a gain of 16, first down Falcons. The first carry now for Tony Pollard. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
Point it right.
Bang.
Watch the safety
That's
screen.
The end of the first quarter with the score Falcons 9. Panthers nothing.
Set. 180.
56. Check 56. You remember me?
Up, Jeff.
Let's go, baby.
Tight dog. Tight 66. Pull it high. Up, Jeff. Hey, Steve Six.
From the 38, Mayfield. That one complete. He finds Sharp. 7 yards there and a first down.
And the Falcons, first down.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10.
Regular.
56.
Throwing, Mayfield. Sharks got it, left side. That throw good for 4. It's 2nd down.
Good stop, Keith.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up 2nd and 6.
Here I come again.
Mayfield. This will be caught inside the 10. Starting to rack up the yardage here in this first half. 5 catches now and a first down.
That's another Falcons first down.
Check 56. Hey, alert.
Let's go.
Here's Jacobs. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. It'll be a 3-yard pickup, and it brings up 2nd and goal. The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on 2nd and goal. Mayfield to throw it. It's caught. Smith. No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be 3rd down. And if you're going to pass down here, you better get that in the end zone.
I agree with you totally. And as we both know, the field's already condensed. There's just not a lot of space. So you've got to create some by getting some people downfield into the end zone. If you want to.
And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Paris Campbell. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Falcons push further out in front.
That score was not a game clincher by any stretch of the imagination. But the other team now has to be careful to not let this game begin to slip away.
Point after, right down the middle. And that could be important as that makes this a 16-point lead. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is taken at his 4. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points get that 0 off the board. So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on 2nd and 12. Here we go on 2nd and 12. And that going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's 3rd down. That pass just a little bit off. It looked like maybe he tried to force it in there.
Game speed, always different, no matter what you do in practice. Can't simulate it, right? So your decision-making, everything has to be a little bit quicker. Sometimes it can throw you off until you adjust.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. He'll look to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. That's a quarterback in for the sack, Tre'Davious White.
The competition comes up in so many different ways, and right now, this unit, their competition is who's going to get to the quarterback the most times. Had about 5 sacks last week. We just saw their first one of this game.
He'll look to set up his blockers. Great blocking, nearly sprung in there. 28-yard return, and the Falcons will be taking over 1st and 10. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. That last drive, it was a good mix. Run, pass, run, pass. Defense on their toes.
And what really helps out in a big way is when you're doing the run-pass mix and everything's working, that means that they're guessing wrong every time on defense. They think you're going to pass when you run and vice versa. I would continue that, and when they finally draw a bead on you, maybe mix it up a little bit, a little play action and throw the ball.
And will they maintain that balance? Time to find out. A 2nd down pass play there, but it's incomplete. So now it's 3rd and long, because remember, they also lose a down on the grounding call. Now Mayfield. And that will be incomplete.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time, make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
Is the punt team now as this one sent away. That'll That'll be a 50-yard punt with 8 on the return. And the Panthers will have a 1st and 10 from deep in their own territory. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last drive, 3 and out. Still a goose egg on the scoreboard. How do they break that goose egg?
They've got to find a way to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers, get them some space, and try and make a first down and get some momentum going. It's been a struggle for them throughout the game, and that 3 and out on the last possession, that told you just how stalled they are on offense.
So who will step up here? We'll see.
Ready to break.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman and have a look back at our first half as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend.
Greystone Travis.
On 2nd down, Eckler trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. The 2nd of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And take it right on the 30. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage. Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. A pass there complete to Sutton. 14 yards there on a Falcon first down. Mayfield now hitting on 80% of his passes in the early going. 8 of 10. It's first down. They go play action. Mayfield. Flushed out right. And this will be incomplete.
Well, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, but frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
An incomplete pass on 1st down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. Here's Mayfield. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. And some room to run now. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Courtland Sutton, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the Falcons push further out in front.
I heard a coach talk about those late-in-the-half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion.
He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Extra point right down the middle. And that pushes the lead up to 23. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This fielded at the two.
Let's go, baby.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
Ready?
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, which you also have to go.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. Raekwon McMillan gets him for a loss of five. He is so tough to handle on the blitz, and that's Exhibit A. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. They don't want to repeat a first down. They'll keep it on the ground. I was pretty surprised there when they lined up to run it on second and long, but it worked out for them.
It certainly did, and that requires some confidence, some fortitude, and a little bit of hope, doesn't it? You hope you catch the defense just right and break off a big run to help yourself out on the next down.
Let's make these babies cry all the way back home, yo. Rock! Rock it. Blue drop Porter. Smith.
Tens the mic. Here we go again.
Ready.
They'll look to throw. He lets it fly for Lockett. And that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's fourth down.
It's always a goal, and it's really nice defensively when you can rally to the football and make sure there's enough contact to force an incompletion.
Force an incompletion and force another punt. That's fielded at the 8-yard line. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. And offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter. Yeah, they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19.
Go, go.
Hey,
alert 33. Hurry. I got it.
Mayfield looks to throw. He's going to look deep down the field. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. incomplete pass 66. Leads to second and 10 from the 25.
He's crashing.
Nice.
Now a give running left is Eckler. And they're able to swarm him behind the line, and his rough night continues.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in the expected passing situation.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
They've got Mike Taylor here.
Hey, Delta.
Back to throw. Going right side here, and that's complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. It's a Panthers first down, 17 yards on the play. On first down, he'll drop to throw. He'll get this to Eckler. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. They'll give him a yard on the play, and that'll make it a second down. Second and nine now. And the catch is made here by Tyler Lockett. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons 42. From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
Choose the mic. Check, 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 check.
Second and 11. And he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first. And it's third down now.
It's third down and 11.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down.
Tens the mic. Tens the mic. I'm going to come back to you.
Hey, dude.
Check, check, check.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Go, go. Yeah, yeah.
They'll set up a throw. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up fourth down. Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth.
Hey, lock it.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. There goes a deep ball in zone. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And a short return to the six-yard line.
Oh, and that's a nice job defensively to get a piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line.
Set the tone, defense. Let's go.
Following the interception, Mayfield. Wide open receiver complete. And they'll get him down up past the 15. It's a gain of 13 and a first down for Atlanta. Thanks to that last play, a little more room to operate. First and 10 at the 18.
Kill, kill, kill. Check 15. Check.
Jacobs now. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and 2.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple.
Word alert!
I got you.
I got you.
He'll have a first down past the 40. And he takes it across the 50 to the 46-yard line. A gain of 28 yards there, and give him a first down.
This is one of those plays that has an equal chance of either being a big gain or a big loss. But with the college influence, we're seeing more of these plays coming to the NFL.
First down, Mayfield. Eluding the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. Cortland Sutton was the man he was looking for. And that'll bring up second down.
I like the boldness, and I like that they took a shot downfield, but it was well covered, and he was able to get a hand in and knock it away.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. To throw, Mayfield. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Brandon, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. The open man is Shark. It's complete. It's a gain of 13 and a first down for Atlanta. Mayfield now, five straight completions here in this second half, first and 10. Mayfield with it once more. Flush to his right. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And finally, wrestled down at the 11. 23 yards, the final tally. A first down throw from Mayfield. And this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Paris Campbell with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year, as his guys continue to pour it on. Out comes the kicking team here for the extra point. And the lead is now an even 30. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
First down, Panthers.
Line of scrimmage moves from their own 25 all the way to the red zone now for first and 10. They'll set up to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down. After the incomplete pass, 70, here now is Indian. Second and 10. Second and 10. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off down near the 5. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
I tell you, Brandon, it seems like this guy's been all over the field so far. That's his second interception of the game. And so much of playing defense in the NFL, especially when it comes to defending the pass, is all about positioning and technique. And this is fantastic work on both fronts there.
They'll run with Pollard to begin the drive. And a gain of about four here moves this from the six up to the 10.
You know how we get focused at end of the half and end of the game situations about how much time's on the board and, you know, what you need to do? Sometimes you don't even have to worry about that. That's just smart football. You know, that kind of a lead, staying in bounds, it burns clock, even in a situation that we're not really focused on it.
A four-receiver set here. Three to the left, one to the right, second and six. Mayfield now. Trying to lay one up deep. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Past the 20. Touchdown, Falcons. DJ Chark. An even 90 yards as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. So from back deep, deep in their own territory all the way into the end zone, you think they expected to score on that one?
I'm not sure they expected to score, but they also show that they're not averse to taking a little bit of a risk there, right? Taking a chance, because the normal call is take care of the football,
run
it, be safe. Instead, they put it in the air and took a gamble, and it paid off in a big way. That wasn't an analytics call. That wasn't a fantasy guy's call. That was like a video game call right there.
It was a little bit of a video game call, but it worked. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it? And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off at the 25. And he'll get this back down to about the 12-yard line. Well, that interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turn to block, find a spot, and now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
Down toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. The linebacker, Zach Cunningham, there defensively to make that play. They're still throwing the football here, and obviously the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense, because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and try and stop any type of a running play. Short little passes may work in exchange of running plays. Keep the clock moving, keep them moving.
I guess you're right. If they can get some first downs, just as good as running the football. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
Alert! Hey, wahoo!
Mayfield. And it's incomplete.
He don't want to throw away this excellent field position, but that's two incomplete passes in a row. Definitely need something big here on third and 10.
Conversely, defense has done a good job on first and second down. The coverage has been draped. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long.
Run.
Working out of the gun, Mayfield. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off down at the two. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. He's on quite the interception run. He had two last week, another one here. Remember, he's not a DB, he's a linebacker.
But how many of those linebackers started as DBs and pumped themselves up into being linebackers? So the ball skills are the same.
right? The coverage skills and responsibilities are the same, and he is paying it off in a big, big way.
They started on the ground with Eckler.
I got you, boy.
And able to get it here to about the 16-yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second down. Once more, here's Eckler. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. The Panthers on third down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. The Panthers on third down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd-and-1. They'll try to pick up the first with Eckler. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. The Panthers have the first. It's a gain of 12. He's had his eyes on 7,000 career rushing yards, and with that last effort, he has hit that mark. What a career.
And that is the number to focus in on, because oftentimes we talk about where do they rank all time. We're not there yet. He's not knocking on the top 10 or the top 20, but over 7,000 yards in a career, fantastic.
Brings up 2nd-and-7 at the 30-yard line.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd-and-7.
Watch out.
6-6, pull it, get it.
A handoff, it's Eckler. They had 3 yards on first down, just 1 yard there.
We know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play.
Four down.
Mike two.
General West.
He'll look to throw. And it's complete. Henry. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. It's a Carolina first down on a gain of 16.
Hey, Foxtrot.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. It's complete to Lockett. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. So they'll come up 1st-and-10 now from the 33. Now back to throw. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off at the 12. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Falcon defense has a touchdown. Now remember, this is the number one defense in the National Football League. There's a good example of why.
Shows that they set an aggressive tone, not just stopping the run, not just getting after the quarterback, but the ball's in the air. They treat it like they're the receivers. And they went after that one and took it all the way.
Now they'll line up to kick the extra point. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead.
Makes the score Falcons 44, Panthers nothing.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Fielded about a yard deep. And he will be marked down right there at the 20-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And following the pick six, and they had decent field position in throwing that pick six, we'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told him, and they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
After the incompletion, here's 61. Second and 10 from the 20.
Tim's the mic. I'm coming for you, son.
Hey, Echo. Go.
He'll drop the throw. It's caught. Lock it. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. It's a Carolina first down on a gain of 16. Back to throw now on first down. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10.
Strip that ball. Mike 10. And we're pretty quiet, D. We're pretty quiet.
Hey, exit.
Hey. 65.
He'll look to throw. And my goodness, another interception. He's picked off at his own 46. And they'll take over inside the 45 at the 44-yard line. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He's going to take a shot right away and give him another six. It's caught for a touchdown, and the blowout continues. And for them, this train, it just keeps rolling, doesn't it? Well on their way to yet another victory.
Yeah, it's almost a runaway, isn't it? And you just wonder how anyone could stop this. They got full momentum going, full confidence going, but it's not just their own confidence that's leading them. It's the lack of confidence against their opponents now, because they see them coming and think, we've got no shot to beat this team.
The extra point up and good, and that will extend this big lead. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told, as he's taken down back shy of the 20. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Panther first down. They held him in check in the first half, but that's his longest carry of the game right there.
So would this be the definition of fresh legs, since he didn't get much done in the first half? Now he has a great opportunity. He's taking full advantage of it.
Check three.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over.
Blue draw Porter. Now.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. Now a run on first down is not going to get off the ground as they will get him behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of three. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Second and 13. And now here is another interception. Tre'Davious White with a pick. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. How about one last great play defensively, and that should, for all intents and purposes, finish off this shutout.
That's as good a defensive performance as we've seen in a long, long time. And I know as a team they will celebrate. I will guarantee you the defensive guys, they'll get together somewhere and have their own private celebration. A shutout, that's something to be cherished.
An ideal beginning of the drive there as they'll get 20 and a first down. Well, the lead late in the fourth, but Mayfield's going to throw it. He'll let this go for the end zone. And this will be caught. And the carnage continues. It's another touchdown.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. Extra point forthcoming. Now, this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this? Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Brian Burns, he's the culprit, and that is now his 13th sack of the season as his great year continues. They get 6 yards back on the run, but still have a third and long situation forthcoming.
Pittsburgh. Buzz. Ready.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 48. So time runs out. It's a victory for the Atlanta Falcons. And I tell you what, Charles, this might be about as good as it gets. They were incredible.
Yeah, offense was in fine form. The defense threw the shutout at them. I think they worked in concert together. What I like about the offense was they held the ball pretty well. You know, time of possession, exactly what they were looking for in this one. And that helped out their defense. Didn't have to be out there the entire time. So when you do that and you're out there fresh playing, off a little extra spring in your step, and it showed up in this one.
They had a ton of spring in their step. Impressive victory. So for Atlanta, they continue to cruise through this first half of the schedule as they move to 8-0 now on the campaign. And they'll get a few extra days to get ready for next week where they take on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Meanwhile, for the Panthers, the loss will drop them to 6-2 now on the year. And they'll try to get back on track next week as they head to Dallas to take on the Cowboys. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.
30,000 in the pocket, no change. Okay, I might pass the ball, but this is no game. Okay, all my girls, they love and hate me the same. Okay, so when I die, I ain't gonna be from old age. Somebody gonna want revenge, somebody might want it now. Right pocket got euros, left pocket got pound, pound. Somebody gonna want revenge, somebody might want it now. Throw the ball with the right hand, catch with the left, touchdown. Step back, let me get some room. Congrats every time I'm through. Same pack, nobody new, so I never get confused. Hotel, get a bird's eye view. Hotel, get a waiting room. Read a magazine while you wait for me. Baby, I'll be done so soon. Phone gotta be off, each door got locks. I got some trusted shoes. Okay. 10K on the countertop, don't look so shocked. It's nothing new. Okay. Death comes in threes. Three. Wins come in twos. Two. Cash comes in ones. One. Throw it up, celebrate some news. Aye. I do a good job, pull up and pop out and pull off. True. Head on and hood on, pedal to metal. When I put my foot on, I got to put on. I got a bad one, they wanna keep me. Oh, that's a good one. Pockets are dense, I think my bread is hard as a crouton. Receipts in my pocket don't come with a coupon. Aye, yeah. Okay, 30,000 in the pocket, no change. Okay, I might pass the ball, but this is no game. Okay, all my girls, they love and hate me the same. Okay, so when I die, I ain't gonna be from old age. Somebody gonna want revenge, somebody might want it now. Right pocket got euros, left pocket got pound, pound. Somebody gonna want revenge, somebody might want it now. Throw the ball with the right hand, catch with the left, touchdown. Touchdown, A floor, come down, hotel, lobby.